Much better. Now, how do we build Octavia? I'm the Kenjineer. Let's solve a practical problem. Octavia has a varied kit, which kind of works together, though focusing on one part at a time allows you to get the most out of any situation. I'll go over three builds which do exactly that, and afterwards show you how you can set up the Mandachord to be as effective as possible in all situations. If you find these builds helpful, then definitely like and subscribe for more guides as I upload them. And if you have any questions about these, you can pop in on the Twitch channel too. First up, we have the Warband, designed with maximum duration, minimum range, and as much strength as can be fit into what's left. The idea is to use Octavia's third ability, Metronome, to keep her cloaked for as long as possible. The ability itself lasts over 60 seconds, while the invisibility lasts 45 seconds on trigger. All you need to do is spam crouch while it's active to trigger the invisibility. As we've got slots to spare to get strength, those go into making Metronome's other features stronger, giving multi-shot or melee damage when triggered. The strength also enhances Warcry. Subsumed onto this Octavia build, Warcry gives about 55% increased attack speed on melee, pairing nicely with the 55% damage buff from Metronome. The range means you're not sharing this with allies, so it is a solo build. You can swap out Narrow-Minded to improve that range, but you lose the staggering 99% duration buff Narrow-Minded brings. The alternative mods to go there are all defensives that you don't really need, or overextended, which kills your strength and invalidates Warcry even being here. If you're not running melee, you can alternatively subsume in Dispensary for general replenishment, or elemental buffs such as Smite. These Octavia builds all use a V and D former. If you're short for former for Octavia Prime, remove the Power Drift and drop down to a standard Intensify mod, and then it'll fit. You lose 29% of your strength in the process, but you keep all of your duration. As for Arcanes, I've used both Energize and Consequence. Energize, of course, is a great source of energy, and Consequence is a mobility arcane, allowing you to get around missions much more quickly. But for this build, you can use pretty much whatever you want though. Next up is the Crowd Conductor, going for maximum range, high duration, and dumping strength. This build can once again use Metronome for invisibility, and this time your allies can join in more easily too. But the heart of this build is Resonator. With maximized range and good duration, Resonator can very easily charm practically every enemy threatening your mission, be it defense, mobile defense, interception, or others. This works for sortie defenses too. As Resonator is Octavia's subsumable ability, this build can be used on any Warframe for the same effect. It isn't a stealth build as it alerts enemies, but it's still total crowd control. Primed Flow isn't necessary, so if you haven't formed Octavia Prime to match, you can simply downrank to a normal flow and keep the rest of the build. Regarding Helminth, you can subsume Spectre Rage onto Octavia with the augment, replacing Augur Message, and give yourself an incredible energy source. I've gone for the same arcanes as with Warband, but again, you can do pretty much what you want here. This is primarily a support Octavia, but nothing stops you from loading up damage boosting arcanes instead, so long as you keep your energy up. As for our third build, it's Endless Beat. As the name suggests, this is for truly endless missions. Using a mid-ranked Narrow-Minded, we can split the duration, range, and strength bonuses fairly evenly to support her mallet ability. While this comes at the cost of efficiency, the combination of damage and duration makes up for it when used correctly. The whole deal with mallet is that it takes damage from enemies and reflects it back to all enemies in the area repeatedly, scaled up 9 times over thanks to both strength and the amp ability. The mallet area is large enough to cover a large room, though it is restricted to line of sight, meaning a more open space is ideal. Unlike basically any other reflection ability, this one actually does solid damage and, as a result, scales forever. There are some caveats you need to know about though before you go diving into whatever survival mission you choose. First, you must always be invisible. This works best when the enemies focus on your mallet and nothing else. If you or anything else they target, such as your cavat, is visible, then this reduces your effectiveness. Second, don't cross the line of fire. Enemies are not perfect shots. so going near the mallet is rather dangerous. Exceedingly so against the Corpus, who for some reason seem to have terrible aim. Third, this build is less effective against Steel Path Grenier and any Infested. Against the Grenier, their high armour makes this build too slow at dealing damage to keep most survival missions going. Outside of the Steel Path, the armour is that much lower that you can maintain, but then why would you want to do a super long endurance mission off the Steel Path these days? As for Infested, Ancient Disruptors really mess up the whole deal with their ability resistance auras. Add on how you can suddenly take toxin damage from other units at random, and it can be quite devastating even to an invisible Octavia. If you're happy to work around these, then fine, but don't say I didn't warn you. Fourth, Arson Xmas units are trouble. They reduce the blast damage taken by them and nearby allies. With just two nearby Arson Xmas units, caustic Xmas units in the Infested, blast damage will be removed from all enemies near to them. If you see Arson Xmas, take them out. I recommend having a look at my Foreman build guide for a weapon which does just this from a safe distance, or you can use radiation procs to prevent the auras from working in the first place. Fifth, watch your noise. While invisible, enemies will target the mallet. However, when you make noise using an alarming weapon, you will sometimes cause nearby enemies to search your location more thoroughly. You can use this to your advantage to lure enemies out of hiding spots, especially enemies like the Acolytes, into the zone of your mallet. Otherwise, a silenced weapon to support you will help avoid disrupting enemy AI. This is another reason I suggest the Foreman, as it can do both on demand. As for missions, the absolute best mission for this build is Mott in the Void. This is because the Void missions connected to Sedna, so-called Tier 4 Void, have an invisible enemy damage boost. Normally this is something you have to work around, but for Octavia, it means the boost to the reflected damage she's dealing. Running this in Mott, you want to set up in a decently open room. It helps immensely if the life support capsules are spawning in that room. There is a backup if you let the kill rate drop too much for a bit. Place your mallet in a central location that's visible to as many pathways as possible for the enemies. Bonus points if it covers the entrances to the room but doesn't see or reach much through them. Place your amp on the mallet so as to double the range and damage. Make sure you stay invisible and swing around picking up loot. And that's it. So long as you keep all three abilities active, keep an eye on your invisibility timer, keep picking up loot and life support, and don't stray into the line of fire, you'll do just fine. Now as for your Mandachord, there's one simple way of doing it, and a slight variation to optimise against the Infested. For your go-to, you want to have the percussion, which affects your first ability, activating at least once every 4 beats. You can do every single beat if you like, though I went with every 4 beats because it makes the damage numbers look slightly nicer to me. The damage dealt by your 1 will scale based on the beat, with more often percussion beats dealing lower damage to average out the whole setup. If you leave too much time between beats, damage will fall off a fair amount before it activates though. The slight variation for Infested is here in this percussion section. Against the Infested, you want to drop the tempo down to 1 percussion note every 8 beats. This is because many Infested are staggered by mallet. If they are staggered, but not dead, they're not getting to the mallet to deal damage to it. This doesn't affect the Grenier or Corpus the same way, as they don't need to get through the entire mallet's range to damage it, and have ample ranged heavy units that resist the staggering effect. Slowing the beat against the Infested gives them time to actually damage the mallet when the damage has tapered off a bit. You can try going to 1 percussion note every 16 beats, though I found that damage drops off too much to keep up a good kill rate at this point. For the bass section, what you do only matters musically. The effect of bass notes on gameplay is as good as nothing. As for melody, you should be putting a note on every single beat. The reason for this is that melody affects how you get the buffs from metronome, and you only get those buffs by doing an action on the beats in which a melody is played. If you have any gaps in the melody, and do the required action in that gap, not only do you not gain any progress towards the desired buff, you actually lose progress to it. It may seem a bit cheesy, but this is what you've got to do to get the most out of Octavia, at least reasonably easily. Those of you who prefer and can make do with a less spammy melody, more power to you, but it's generally not great. Now if you're using just a mechanical mandachord that sounds like absolute ass, please use the volume mixer to mute your sounds. It doesn't affect your gameplay at all, so just do it. And if you're like me and struggle to appreciate any Mandachord setup for more than 5 seconds, you can mute every Octavia in the game in your settings to never have to deal with the cacophony some players choose to bring. Alright, you got your builds, you got your Mandachord. As Teshin puts it,
"Your weapons make music, and the enemy calls for a song."
I hope this video has helped you. Give it a like if it did. And once again, don't forget to subscribe. And as always, drop beats, strike chords, and fight well, Tenno.